Hi, welcome to an Arduino tutorial from RoboJax. In this video I'm going to show you how we can use multi-turn or continuous, or sometimes they call it 360 servo. This servo can be small or big, but we are going to learn in this video how can we rotate it in one direction and the other direction, or we can stop it something like this. For example, if I want to say make it left, so it rotates left, or if I want right, I can rotate it right, and if I want to stop it, I can stop it something like that. You can get the code for this project by clicking at the link in the description below, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. Let's get started with this. Unlike this tiny servo that rotates in up to 180, for example, if I enter L, so this goes to full 0 degree, and if I enter R, it goes to 180. This continuous servo, or 360 sometimes people call it, will not stop, because we don't know where it will stop. It will continue rotate, and that's a big problem in terms of understanding the position, unless you use other means, some kind of sensor here, and the position of this, and as soon as it rotates. So you have to do two things. First, you have to find the exact location of starting point, and also then after that the direction of rotation. So you have to record it through other means, and then after that you will be able to fully control this and stop it and change the direction. But if you don't do that, you will be able to just change the direction left or right, or stop it. In this video I'm going to show you how you can do that. So can you rotate it to one direction, and you can rotate it on the other direction, or stop it. Depending on the quality of your servo, you will be able to fully stop it, and it needs some experiment to achieve that. And in this video I'm gonna explain through the code, and also do practically show you how this works. So this continuous servo could be this size, or maybe this size, or maybe even bigger, but it doesn't matter. The functionality is the same, except the quality and sensitivity of the servo is determining how much control you have over the movement of this 360 servo. And it's actually this package. When you enter the values here on serial monitor, you're actually entering any letter that you have will be in terms of ASCII characters. For example, if you enter K, you're actually entering 107, so the Arduino is converting it. So you have to have a means or a mechanism to understand what it is and then use it. For that reason you need to use this ASCII table. Just do a Google or Bing search and then find the table. I'm just using it as an image here, and most of the value that I will use will be around here. I'm entering left, or L, which is 108, and then I'm entering just R, which is 114, and then I detect and check if it's 108, I'm sending one value to the servo, and it's 114, I'm sending another value manually. And then for stopping, I'm using one of these values, and based on experiment, it's supposed to be 90 that stop the capital Z, but in my case it did not work, so I have to change it, and it came to be around 60 to 69, these values, so less than sign and all those, which I'm going to show you practically which one stops my servo, but you will do the same thing. So the program that I will offer you will help you find that what value your servo starts stops, not start. But the left and right turning will be very easy, because we are sending one command left or right, and then accordingly we will be able to change the direction of it. Let me now explain the code. I've used the servo library, which is included with any IDE, Arduino IDE, and this is just creating the object of this class, my servo. You can change it to anything that you want, but through the code you have to use the same word. And then the position variable, this is not being used. Incoming data, this is used when you type something from the command line. And this is 9600 baud. The value is the value that is used here, so it must match. And then pin 9 is the pin that is used to control the servo. And inside the loop, which starts from here to here, this line which says serial.available, that means if there is a value and it's bigger than 0, which means there is not empty space. So when you enter something, so it will return true and will continue. Otherwise, it will not. So then it will go. It goes to serial read. Whatever you enter, it goes and stores an incoming byte. And then this is just printing the character, the text that we have here. So you will see that. And then we'll print the value. So this is the actual value. For example, if you enter a value which is a character which is left, L is equal to this value. After this, we check if it's 108, which is L, then we say sent. So that is this sent, and then we say zero. Sent zero rotating clockwise. Sent zero rotating clockwise. And then what we do is we send zero right to my servo. So this is the one that command is sent to the servo to change the direction. So this doesn't mean it's rotating right or left. And that is a problem. Way you have to find out when you turn it on which way it rotates, because it's very random. But this, whatever direction it is, it will just change it. And then we say else if it's R, which is 114. And this is a value, so R, small r, 114. Then we print the 114, and then after that we also show that it's going 180 is sent. So we are sending 180, but also printing this text. So this is the value that is sent. So first we sent to make it rotate in one direction, and now we are sending 180. So we are sending either 0 or 180. And then here the value from my experiment was that if we put around 60, then we also print the text stopped. So this is, you have to experiment and find out what value it is from the this ASCII character table. So initially less than sign was sending 60 and stop, but as the servo worked and get hotter, or maybe whatever it is, after a moment, few moments, it changed. So greater than equal sign on earth. So values close to around 60 was stopping the servo fully. And then we say if the value is not this value that you have experimented, then we just say random value, and then whatever value you have will be transferred to the servo. This time we're sending 60, 0, 180, but here whatever you enter, let's say you enter 62, 62 will be transferred. And the loop continues like that. Now let me explain the wiring, because this needs at least 500 or 550 milliampere, and Arduino is not able to supply that with 5 volts. So I've connected it to external power supply that can supply that current. The positive of that signal, so power supply, is connected to the middle of this, which is connected to 5 volts, and then the ground of this one is connected to Arduino, and also I've connected another ground here. So the ground of Arduino and this must be common. So this is connected to power supply, and two of these are ground are connected. And then the line that is an input signal for this is connected to pin 9, and we are sending pulses modulation to this device. The wiring is the same as this small servo, no difference, except this servo, if you're not putting load on it, can work directly with this Arduino and you don't need external power. Now let me demonstrate it. As you can see here, this is now powered up and it's totally stopped. And here we have used, it says random moving, I put it, because depending on the circuitry and the type of the servo, you will have to enter different value. So we have a serial monitor here open, and here I have opened the ASCII characters that we are entering these values, and the value that is transferred to the servo will be this value, this column, which is a decimal value. Right now, when I enter L, which means left, I just put randomly left because clockwise, counterclockwise would have been a little complicated, so made it simple, and I put this point so we can see which way this is rotating. Right now I'm entering L, lowercase L, and it's rotating left, and then left and right doesn't matter because it depends at what state this servo has started it. And if I put R here, R814, and to show you that R814, this is the 114 and I entered R. So for L, this will be 108. For that reason, you see these two values. And if I reset this, Arduino, you will see that this is rotating in some random direction. So that's we have to keep in mind. And now if I enter L or R, doesn't matter. We just need to disturb it and give another value. So if I enter L, which means I entered 108, but 0 was sent. So what we do is we send 0 or 180, and then R will send 180. To change the direction of this, we just need to enter 0 or 180. Now the problem is how we can stop it. In order to stop it, I've experimented this. Theoretically, we have to enter something between 180 and 0, which is 90. But 90 will not be able to do the job for us here. And 90 is capital Z. So now if I enter capital Z, it just slowed a little. It did not work, so I tried different values, and it turns out that this device will be turned off around 68 or 65. And let's test it. For example, I'm entering equal sign, which is 61. I entered equal sign and pressing enter. Now this is stopped, but still it seems there is a little juggling, and it now stopped. So if I enter instead of the equal sign, so I don't know if you can hear it. I'm getting it closer to microphone. So this is now, so I have to increase the value. I'm putting greater than sign. No change. Let me put equal sign. Still at stopped it. But because this is a threshold current, slowly within a few minutes it might change or it might not, depending the type of the servo and how reliable and how high quality the servo is. It seems this is not as high quality as I was expecting. You see the buzzing. So I have to enter now capital A, B or C and D, and they're all capital letters starting with A. As you can see here, the value that you see is 61, 62, 63, 64. So I've entered 64, which is question mark at, and then I'm entering capital A. Now stopped. Let's enter capital B. Still good. Capital C. Capital D. it start moving to the other direction. When I touch it, I hear the vibration. Slowly it's trying. So in order to jump a little farther, let's say if I enter in, it has started, but it is slow. Meaning if you enter a value between 0 and 180, you can change the speed of this. So let me enter L, which is 100 and which is 0, and R 180. But we can go something in between those values and get this. But in order to stop it, I can enter capital A. And as you can see, it's still juggling. So I have to go B, C, capital D, capital E, capital F. No, it means I have to go smaller. Equal fine, stopped it fully. And still, you see now it starts buzzing. So you will try it and find the value. I believe internal electronic circuit of this is determining at what value it will fully stop. But theoretically, it's supposed to be stopped at 90. In a few minutes or seconds, maybe the resistors, other components will heat up, and the threshold of stopping this will change. But still, it seems it's working. So 64 was, for example, I found that is working. The at. This was how to use this continuous or 360 servo using Arduino or control it. Please subscribe so you can get updates of my upcoming videos, and also thumb up the video and share it. I appreciate it. If you have comment or question, please post it below in the comment section. I'll try to answer and reply.